Hello, so here is the second part dedicated to bishop c6 line, d4, knight f6, c4, e6, g3, d5, knight c3, bishop e7, bishop g2, castles, d takes c4, knight e5, knight c6, bishop c6, b takes c6, knight takes c6, queen e8, knight e7, and queen e7, and here queen c2. Queen c2 or queen a4, it makes some difference, because when white is trying to play queen c2, the move c5 is actually possible, but I will focus on a5, because I think that move is playable. The only moment is this move d takes e5 that was played in the Tomaszewski Nakamura game. Queen takes e5, bishop f4, queen h5, knight c3. And here, in such positions, when white knight is already on c3, our main idea is to exchange the knight. So knight d5, quite a logical move. Knight d5, queen takes d5, rook d1, queen c6. So I think that black is just okay in that kind of position, because the pawn on c4 is not a weakness. We can protect it from the e6, and this diagonal is bad for white, because white will try to play something like f3, e4. But after bishop e6 and rook d8, I don't see any particular advantage for white. The engine gives something like 0.3, but I don't believe in white's position, so it's an interesting line to try to explore further, but everyone plays rook d1. And what it is about. So black tries bishop b7 with the idea getting queen to the h3. For example, in one game, queen c4 was played and queen d7. And now it's a good moment for white to actually give the d pawn back by playing d5. Otherwise, the black's attack can be very strong. So d5, bishop d5, queen h4. But queen e6, no problems at all for black. Another move is bishop g5, pinion the knight, rook d8, and in the Lichao game he tried queen c4, but that's already a mistake, because after it takes d4, just queen e4 is a devastating threat, so knight d2, but now the d4 pawn can be taken back, and black is just better. d5 is the move again, but after rook d5, rook d5, bishop d5, knight c3, white actually is pawn down, so black has no problems at all. So the main idea of the queen c2, rook d1 line is to play here knight c3, so white wants to play something like e4 and f3, and the knights are still on the board, and the c4 pawn is weakness. So we should know what to do. Black can try queen e6 or queen d7, it really doesn't matter, because after d takes e5, black plays queen h3. So here f3 is bad move because of knight g4. That idea of this attack is devastating. White should try e4, but after knight e5, the black's attack continues. So e4, knight g4, and f4. And here is the difference between queen a4 line and queen c2 line, because here white can play in such style because the queen is protected the second rank. And black tries rook a8, and very complicated position arises. So if white is solid enough, he may try to play queen g2, but after queen g2, king g2, rook d1, knight d1, bishop a4, black took the pawn back. Yes, the c pawn is a weakness, but after some more moves, king g1, bishop c2, white is forced to play knight e3, and this ending is a drawish one. For example, rook b8, cd5, and rook d8 with the move rook d1, so it's just a drawish position. The other try can be rook d8, rook d8, queen g2, queen h6, h3, like in the game when you against when you. And here the Chinese prodigy should took on e4, very strong move, because queen e4, queen h3 was devastating attack. Queen e4, I meant knight e4, rook d1. Queen e4 must be played. Queen b6, and here is the black's idea, because now if the king moves somewhere, white is losing. So bishop e3 should be played, knight e3, and here knight e4, otherwise black attack is just very strong. Queen d4, queen d4, rook d4, knight, king f2, knight f5. And this endgame is actually unequal after something like rook c1, h5. Yes, black has bad pawn on c4 and on c7, but these pawns are actually also bad. And here comes the most interesting line of this video. It is knight d5. Here black should try f5. And a very complex position arises. The main idea is that e takes f6 is just losing after rook f8. Black wants to take on f4 with devastating attack, and for example f takes g7, rook e4, and queen e4 is impossible due to such mate. So knight e7 was white's idea. King f7, rook d8, rook d8. And the idea rook d1 is also very nasty. No bishop d2 due to the queen takes h2. So queen takes c4, and here comes the shocking rook d5, and white just loses. Queen e2, rook d1. But sometimes white just go into this crazy position. And the choice is rook e1. And here already I want to show you a novelty. By the way, this line is not presented in Jan Gustafsson's video series. And rook e1 is just a good move. White now wants to play knight e7. And then take on f5 with a knight. So black should do something, and that move is Rook d7, aiming against knight e7. And here b3 is the main line. White can try queen g2 here, but that's just nothing. Queen takes g2, king takes g2, f takes e4, knight e3, knight e3, bishop e3, and the endgame is drawish. Also, knight e3 can be played with the idea after bishop e4, queen c4, king h8 to play queen e2 and to exchange knights. But here comes black's drawish combination: rook d3, knight g4, rook g3, h takes g3, queen takes g3, king f1, queen h3, king f2, queen h4, and white just can progress. It's better to play king f1 because after king e3, rook d8, just bad position. So the engine's first choice is to play b3 here, and black is playing c3, otherwise white can take c4. So after b3 c3, e6 now can be played, and bishop d5, the sacrifice of the exchange. E takes d7, bishop takes e4. Here, if queen e2, then black should attack with the h pawn, h5, bishop a3, h4, g takes h4, and now knight takes h2, queen takes h2, and the perpetual check of the queen g4, king f2, queen f3, king g1, queen g4. So after rook e4, f takes e4, bishop a3, and the d7 pawn is actually a good one. So rook d8 attacking this pawn, rook d1, and again h5 with the idea h4, rook d4 preparing queen g2, h4, queen g2, queen g2, king g2, and king f7. The engine shows now 0.0, but the position remains complex. For example, bishop c1, c5, rook c4, e3, g takes h2, e2, rook e4, and rook takes d7. Here, if rook e2, then rook d1, king f3, knight f6, bishop e3, knight d5, bishop c5, rook d3, king e4, rook d2, and if king f3, then rook d3 with a draw. And if king f3, then rook d2 is the easiest draw. For example, rook takes e2, knight h2, king e3, knight g4 with a perpetual check. And if king takes g4, rook a2, king f3, rook c2, bishop a3, there is rook a2, and after bishop c1, rook c2. And it's also a draw. So, very tactical computerish line. Of course, you should know it, but why and how you can remember all such things? Because knight d5 is already the 17th move. But it's a modern chess theory. You must know everything, and if you are good enough, you can do draws. Yes, chess is a very boring game now when both players are well prepared. So thank you for watching this video, and see you in the next one.